Now, this doesn't mean the army wasn't there, perhaps far behind the front lines or far above Aleppo, waiting in faraway fields for 0 hour, they may be passing their time. The Syrians have loudly announced their intention of crushing the last terrorist bastion in Idlib province. I can confirm the Syrian jets took off from the Hama airbase in the morning at around 8:30 a.m. because I could hear air roar a mile away over breakfast. But I saw no smoke clouds drifting down from Jisr Shabur or east of Idlib a couple of hours later as I watched from the all-too-smashed security supply route up to Aleppo. A known low-flying Russian-made Syrian helicopter came thudding over the desert near Abu Adur, whose own airbase was recaptured by Syrian troops last year. Just one. What I did find on my 300-mile tour around the frontier of Idlib province. At the old Kassab border crossing, the Turks are still building a massive concrete wall along the Syrian frontier, topped with barbed wire and arc lights below a cloud-shrouded mountain on which stood, just visible, a range of reconnaissance aerials. From there, a Syrian captain told me NATO wants Syria and could probably listen to Syrian communications, although the Syrians could apparently not listen to NATO. I climbed the staircase of a broken house, its former Nusra forces graffiti painted out on the internal walls, and stared across the Turkish border.